Nigerian youths, arise. Edo youths, arise. This is our time. This change is all about us. We have to take this opportunity offered by this change to change Edo State, to develop Edo State, and make Edo State work again. We need to vote for a young person who will bring innovations, new ideas into governance. Youth engagement is now. This is the time. I strongly believe that anything about us, without us, is not for us. Yes, I mean it. Anything about us, without us, is not for us. Today, let us do something new. This is change. Change is voting and nominating Blessing Agbomhere. Change is when Blessing Agbomhere becomes the governor of Edo State. You don't talk about change, and you are bringing in old and recycled ideas. When you talk about change, you talk about freshness, you talk about newness. I am the new face of Edo. I am the fresh face of Edo. And I carry this dream, this new dream for Edo State. With me, Edo State will experience newness. With those other people, Edo State will experience what they have experienced before. Nominating me means change for Edo people. It means change in our infrastructural life. It means change in our common life. Because we are not ready to do the things that other governments have been doing. We are ready to probe this government when they hand over to us. Any government that has existed in Edo, we must go back to the records. We must go back to the books to know where the mistakes were made. We cannot go forward without addressing the issues of the past. Addressing the issues of the past is correcting the past for a smooth future. So we will probe past government, as I said before. We will make them accountable because government is supposed to be accountable to the people. If we vote you in, when you serve us, you must render account of your service. The Constitution of Nigeria upholds accountability, which is pro. So that when we initiate the pro, we will also subject ourselves to pro when our government is expiring. And with so doing, or by so doing, every government that comes to power will know that they are coming to serve the people. And after you finish serving the people, you must give account of stewardship. Then the people will assess you. They will judge you. If you did well, they will clap for you. They will celebrate you. They will give you honors and awards. But if you did wrongly, you will be condemned. You will be made to right the wrongs. And by so doing, our society will begin to celebrate righteousness. Today we celebrate corruption because our leaders are not accountable. The constitution of our country guarantees accountability. Accountability is an issue, and we make it an issue. If we're a local government chairman, we begin to account for whatever he has done or is doing in his administration. The commissioner will give account. So I re-emphasize the fact that when I become the governor of Edo State, we will probe past governments. When you're handing over, you hand over books, you hand over notes. Are you saying that if you hand over notes, we should not look at them, we should go and keep them? No, we will look at them. Looking at them means probe. Looking at them is probe. If you have done well, we will give you a pat at the back. We will celebrate you and we will continue from where you have stopped. But if you have not done well as a past government or as a past governor, we will make you right the wrongs. By so doing, we are setting a good note. And those who take over government will know that when you're also leaving, you will be proud. And because of that, you will ensure that every season, every period, every accounting period, you must render your books and you must give account of your stewardship. So I believe in Edo. I believe in the workability of Edo. Edo will work under us. Edo will work under the young people of Nigeria. Edo will work under the young people of Edo State. Edo will work because we have talented young people who have this burning passion to contribute their quota to the development of their state. But they have been denied. They have been deprived. And that is why Nigeria is the way it is, because young people have been deprived. Nigeria is like this because young people have been denied access to governance. Edo is where it is today with the level of technology around the world, because the young people of Edo State have been deprived from engaging in government positions where they can take decisions that will affect their lives and their communities. So this is the time for youth engagement. This is the time for us to be engaged in government. And this is the best time because President Muhammadu Buhari has promised youth engagement. He has promised youth empowerment. I also believe that the best way President Muhammadu Buhari can curb corruption and sustain his legacy in Nigeria is to engage young people in governance. Engage them as governors, engage them as ministers, engage them as DGs and managers of organizations and parastatals. Without the youth engagement in Nigeria, I am bold to tell you that Nigeria will not grow. Nigeria will not develop. Because if you believe in the future of this country, it becomes a necessity and a duty for the young people of this country to be trained, for them to be mentored, for them to be engaged in governance. So engage, youth engagement in governance begins with me. As the governor of Edo State, nominate me, vote for me, support me, and we will all change Edo State.
Edo Youth for Blessing Agbomhere.